Good morning, children. In this session, we are going to study about the fraction and ascending descending order under the chapter tens and hundreds. Our first heading is write a fraction. The first problem, 48.56. Children, you write the number except the decimal point. Listen, 4856. Here I did not put the decimal point. Instead of, you put or you draw the division symbol divided by, then you count the digit, children. 1, 2. I underline, you know, 2-digit underline here. So in the denominator I add 2, 0, 1, 2. So that is 100. So our answer 4856 divided by 100. Our second problem, 42.1. So after the decimal point, how many digit we have, children? Just we have one. So I write the same number without the decimal. So in numerator I have 421 divided by 10. I put just I have to add only 1 0, because here after the decimal I have 1 digit, so I add 1 0 in the denominator, so I get 10. Our answer 421 divided by 10. Our third problem, 75.498. After the decimal, you count, children, 1, 2, 3. So I underline 3 digit. So in the denominator, I add 3 zeros. So I get 1000. In numerator, I write the number except the decimal. Is it clear? Except the decimal, you write down in the numerator how many digit after the decimal point you have, that much zeros you have to add. So you get 1000. Our answer 75,498 divided by 1000. Children, our second heading, convert into a like decimal. The first problem, 75.98, 69.4 and 82.704. In this problem, first after the decimal, how many digits we have, you count, children? Here after the decimal, 1 2. Here after the decimal, 1 digit. Here after the decimal, 1 2 3. So after the decimal, how many maximum number of digit we have, you count, children? So here 3 is the maximum number we get after the decimal point. After the decimal, we need 3 digit in each given number, children. We try to convert likewise, children. So here after the digit we have, after the decimal we have 2 digit. We need 3 digit. Instead of the third one, I put 0, children. Now you count 1, 2, 3. In the given problem, we have 2 digit alone. I add 1 0, So I get 3 digits. So this is now converting to like fraction. So next step, after the decimal, one place only we have, one digit only we have. So how many zeros we need to add for each 3 digit? So 1, 2, 3. I add 2 0, then I get the 3 digit after the decimal. The last one, no need to change anything. This is the maximum number of decimal after the decimal point. Maximum number of digit after the decimal point. So this is our solution for the second heading, children. Children, our third heading, arrange the following in ascending order. Our problem: 0.96, 3.762, 0.42, 8.643. Children, you know very well the ascending order is we arrange the number smaller number to greater number. First, we arrange the numbers one by one. Next, you try to find which is the smallest one. So, see here, before the decimal point, we have 2 zeros. So, first we take these 2 numbers. Next, after the decimal, here we have 4. Then, after here, we have 9. So, which is the smallest? 4. So, I give a number 1 here. Next, this is our number 2. Then remaining we have these 2 numbers. So you refer these 2 number. Here before the decimal we have 3. Here we have 8. So which one is the greater? 8 is the greater. So which one is smaller? 3. So I given number 3 here. The remaining is at last one, 4. So now we can arrange the number in ascending order easily. Which comes first? This one, 0.42. The second one, 0.96. You taken right, children? Then 3.762. At last, 8.643. You try to arrange yourself, children. Our fourth heading, arrange the following in a descending order. Our problem, 0.48, 6.98, 0.64 and 3.67. First, we try to arrange the numbers one by one, children. Then only you can find the numbers easily, which is the smaller, which is a greater. So descending means we have to arrange the number greater to smaller. So before the decimal, you see I have 2 zeros, so leave it. The remaining these 2 numbers you have to refer, 6 and 3. So 6 is the greater. I given number 1. Then the 3 I given number 2. The remaining the 2 zeros, you know. Now you compare these 2. After the decimal, why I leave and go to after decimal means before the decimal we have the same 0. So only I move to after the decimal. I have 4 here. I have 6 here. So which is the greater? So 6. I given the number 3 here. The remaining I give a number 4. Now you can arrange easily, children. You put the heading a descending order. Then you take and write first one is 6.98, So around 6.98. Then the second number where it is here, that is 3.67. So I write down second one 3.67. Go through the third one. Here is the third one 0.64. So 0.64. Then the fourth one 0.48. I have written 0.48. So now we complete the descending order, children. In this session, we study fraction form. Second one, like decimal, convert into like decimal, ascending order, and descending order. I hope you are all study well. Thank you, children.